大家好，我是 Stella，
我是 Warren。 今天要为您念的是练习手册复习四 Review 4第144课。我的心灵只怀有与上主共同的想法。 My mind holds only what I think with God。
127，除了上主的爱以外，没有其他的爱存在。127. There is no love but God.
128. 眼前的世界没有我真正想要的东西。
128. The world I see holds nothing that I want.
以下是这熊的释义。 You are blessed beings indeed. 你确实是有福之人。 I am that one that you know as Jesus. And these are challenging lessons for the ego-ruled mind. And you must understand that. You are not necessarily going to be comfortable with these ideas because you have been taught that your thoughtsare your own. 我是你所知的 JC。 对于被小我掌控的心灵来说，这几课的观念是深具挑战的。你必须了解，你未必会对这些观念感到自在，因为你被教育了你的想法是你自己的这个观念。 And this is one of the errors that you have been laboring under, because when you thinkthat your thoughts are all your own. You are assuming that you have absolute free will over what has been put into your mind, and you have not had that. 这是你受误导的错误观念之一。你若认为你的想法完全是你自己的，你便是假定你对于输入自己心中的想法有完全的自由意志，但事实并非如此。 You have had many instructions in your society early on in your development, deeply embedded through repetitive and, at times, traumaticindoctrination, and these are still there. 你在人生发展的早期，从社会中接受到许多的指令，那些指令是透过反复，有时令人痛苦的方式而灌输给你，并深植在你心中，因此它们仍旧存在在你心中。 So those beliefs that are still there in your mindThey were adopted by the ego mind as a form of survival. So, for example, if you were 2 years old and you got in a lot of trouble when you didn't eat your peace and your mother withdrew love from you or punished you or forced fed you, you would have learned a particular behavior during that time to keep you safe. 那些依旧存在你心中的信念，被你心中的小我这部分所采纳，作为一种生存的方式。举例而言，如果你是2岁的孩子，当你不吃豌豆时，你会惹上麻烦。此时，你的母亲学会对你的爱，或是惩罚你，或是强迫为你，因此你在这段期间学到一种特定的行为以维护自己的安全。 And this would have been the ego saying, it doesn't matter what you want, you have to just keep this body alive. It is a survival mechanism, a very primitive frequency in a sense. 此时小我会说，你想要什么并不重要，你只需维持这具身体的存活，这是一种生存机制，意思是这是一种非常原始的振动频率。 And so you would have developed a behavior, let us say. You began to cave in to eating what other people wanted you to eat because you got in so much trouble. Even though you were just a little baby, you got in trouble, or your mother abandoned you, turned her way back on you, punished you, gave you a nasty face, which of a little being is very traumatic. It is very awful being force-fed. 因此你会发展出一种行为，比如说你开始妥协，而吃他人要你去吃的东西，因为你过去惹了太多麻烦。即使你只是一个小婴儿，你也会惹麻烦。你的母亲丢下你，不理你，处罚你，或是给你不好的脸色看，对小婴儿来说这是非常痛苦的事情。被强迫喂食是一件非常糟糕的事。 And you may have a weight problem now, but you have no recollection of the trauma. It is deep in the subconscious mind, and that belief and that coping mechanism, however, will generate thought and feelings. 现在你可能有体重过重的问题，但是你不记得那些创伤，它深藏在潜意识下。然而那种信念及应付机制会产生种种想法和感觉。 And you may find yourself struggling to eat healthily and having a desire for a healthy figure, a healthy body, but you can't maintain it because that deep programming has been embedded in you. 你可能会发现自己很难吃得健康，你渴望自己有个健康的身材及健康的身体，但是你无法维持，因为那种思想程式在你心中已经根深蒂固。 So when you say things like I am only thinking thoughts that God thinks, or that God's love is the only love there is, we are gently reprogramming you back to truthBut you may not believe it yet. 因此，当你想着我的心灵只怀有与上主共同的想法，或是除了上主的爱之外，没有其他的爱存在，这类观念时，我们是在温和地重新输入程式，让你回到真理之中。但是你可能还不相信。 And that is okay because we areoverriding and we are counteracting and we are contradicting many of the thought and beliefs and ideas that you experience every day in your normal ego-driven mind. 这是无妨的，因为我们正在替换，我们正在解决你每天通常受小我主导的心灵所经历的许多想法、信念和观念。 So if these beliefs seem a little highfalutin or out of your ability to reach them, be patient with yourself. 所以说，如果你觉得这些信念看似有点浮夸，或是超乎你的能力所及，请耐心等待自己。 We are counteracting thoughts and beliefs and ideas already existent in the mind, and the ego has developed those to keep you safe, to keep you from being punished or hurt. 我们正在解除早已存在你心中的那些想法、信念和观念，小我发展出那些观念来维护你的安全，避免你遭到惩罚或伤害。 And it will send up a warning signal that you are stepping into treacherous territories. Try to reprogram the mind because it has done this after all to keep you from getting in trouble. 它会传递你一个警讯，告诉你你已经步入危险之地，而且它试图重新调整你的想法，因为终究来说，它所做的一切都是要避免你陷入麻烦。 And so you might feel like a very strong argument comes up to some of these lessons. It does not matter.因此你在练习这几课时，可能会感觉到一种非常强烈的争论浮上心头，这无关紧要。 You can observe that argument and go, wow, my mind really disagrees with this. Very interesting. 你可以观察这些争论而说 wow, 我的内心确实不认同这个观点。非常有趣。Try not to allow the thought of disagreement or argument win. Do your lessons diligently and faithfully, and all will begin to change slowly but surely into a much more peaceful mind. 同时试着不要让否定的想法或争论获胜，怀着信心勤加练习这些课程，一切将会缓慢但必然的改变，你的心灵会变得更加平安。I am that one that you know as Jesus, and I'll see you again tomorrow. 我是你所知的 JC, 我们明天再会。
我的心灵之怀有与上主共同的想法。My mind holds only what I think with God. 除了上主的爱以外，没有其他的爱存在。There is no love but God's. There is no love but God's. 眼前的世界没有我真正想要的东西。The world I see holds nothing that I want.
作文第十四章真理的教诲 Chapter 14 Teaching for Truth
第五节救赎之人 5 The Circle of Atonement
你的心灵与上主依旧紧密相连的那部分才是唯一真实的部分。 The only part of your mind that has reality is the part that links you still with God.你可愿把它全部转化为上主之爱的光明讯息，分享给所有因否认了它而陷于孤独的人。 Would you have all of it transformed into a radiant message of God's love to share with all the lonely ones who have denied Him. 上主会让你如愿以偿的。 God makes this possible. 你岂能拒绝他被人了知的渴望？ Would you deny his yearning to be known? 因你对他的思念不亚于他对你的思念。 You yearn for him as he for you. 这是永恒不易的事实。 Accept.Them, the immutable. 将死亡的世界抛诸身后，悄悄地回归天堂。Leave the world of death behind and return quietly to heaven. 这个世界毫无价值，所有的价值都在天上。There is nothing of value here and anything of value there. 听从圣灵的指示吧。你会由他那儿听到天父的话语。Listen to the Holy Spirit and to God through him. 他会告诉你有关你的真相。He speaks of you to you. 你内不可能存有罪疚的，因上主需要圣子的祝福，如同圣子需要上主的祝福一样。There is no guilt in you.For God is blessed in His Son, as the Son is blessed in Him. 每个人在救赎计划里都负有特殊的任务，但每个人领受的讯息却是同一个，上主之子清白无罪。Everyone has a special part to play in the atonement, but the message given to each one is always the same.God's Son is guiltless. 每个人都会以不同的方式传达这一讯息，也会从不同管道学到这一讯息。Each one teaches the message differently and learns it differently. 在他边教边学这个讯息之前，内心必然常有任务未了的隐痛。Yet, until he teaches it and learns it, he will suffer the pain of dim awareness that his true function remains unfulfilled in him. 那种罪疚感沉重无比，上主不愿你被他束缚。The burden of guilt is heavy, but God would not have you bound by it. 它是你的觉醒计划完美无比，只有你自己的计划才会错误百出。His plan for you awaking is as perfect as yours is fallible. 你不知道自己该做什么，幸好无所不知的圣灵始终与你同在。You know not what you do, but he who knows is with you. 他的仁慈亦存于你心内，还会为你呼求上主与你同有的大爱。His gentleness is yours, and all the love you share with God, he holds in trust for you.他要教你的只有一事，就是如何幸福地活下去。He would teach you nothing except how to be happy. 你是深受天父祝福的圣子，他为你创造了喜乐。Blessed son of a holy blessing father, joy was created for you. 凡是上主祝福的，谁能定他的罪？Who can condemn whom God has blessed? 凡是活在天心内的，必有上主的纯洁无罪。There is nothing in the mind of God that does not share his shining innocence. 一切造化只是那完美圣洁的本体之自然延伸。Creation is the natural extension of perfect purity.上主召唤你自愿献出这一生，在一切事上任何形式下否认罪疚的存在。 Your only calling here is to devote yourself with active willingness to the denial of guilt in all its forms. 只要还想畏罪于人，表示你仍不解真相。 To accuse is not to understand.唯有献身于救赎的快乐学徒，才可能成为教导纯洁无罪的教师，纯洁无罪的是上主召化的天父权力。The happy learners of the atonement become the teachers of the innocence that is the right of all that God created.切莫否认他们这一天赋，你若有所保留，伤害到的绝不仅止于他们而已。Deny them not what is their due, for you will not withhold it from them alone. 天国是上主在创造之初赐给圣子的产业。The inheritance of the kingdom is the right of God's Son, given him in his creation. 不要企图窃走他的天国，否则你会自食罪疚的苦果。Do not try to steal it from him, or you will ask for guilt and will experience it.保护上主之子的圣洁吧，莫让任何念头盗取他的圣洁，使他视而不见。Protect his purity from every thought that would steal it away and keep it from his sight. 切莫遮掩他的圣洁而因照穿醉酒的沉沉面纱，使他看到上主之子的面容。Never allowPurity to remain hidden, but shine away the heavy veils of guilt, within which the Son of God has hidden himself from his own sight. 如此，我们才算结合于救赎之内， 此外，世上没有一物能够将我们结合在一起。We are all enjoyed in the atonement here, and nothing else can unite us in this world.分裂的世界终将消逝，天父及圣旨必会恢复全面交流的。So will the world of separation slip away and full communication be restored between the Father and the Son. 是因心灵已经否认了自己的无罪本质，才需要奇迹为你指认心灵的无罪，为你带来疗愈。The miracle acknowledgesThe guiltlessness that must have been denied to produce the need of healing. 欢喜地认出它吧，不要有任何保留，因为幸福与解脱都寄望于此。Do not withhold this glad acknowledgement for hope of happiness and release from suffering of every kind.Lie in it. 有谁不希望由痛苦解脱? Who is there but wishes to be free of pain? 即使他尚未学会如何以无罪来取代罪疚，也不明白唯有这样取代才有摆脱一切痛苦的可能。He may not yet have learned how to exchange guilt for innocence, nor realize that only in this exchange can freedom from pain be his. 然而尚未学会这一课题的人特别需要开导而非攻击。Yet, those who have failed to learn need teaching, not attack.你一旦攻击那些有待学习的人，便再也无法从他们身上学到任何东西了。To attack those who have need of teaching is to fail to learn from them. 宣扬纯洁无罪的教师们，即使各有所思，能人同心协力为自成一体的救赎课程刻进一份能力。Teachers of innocence, each in his own way, have joined together, taking their part in a unified curriculum of the atonement. 除此之外，没有任何学习目标能够如此自成一体。There is no unity of learning goals apart from this.这课程不会自相抵触，教学的形式虽有万千，目标永远只有一个。There is no conflict in this curriculum, which has one end, however it is taught. 你为它付出的每一份心血，都会将你导向这一目标，也就是由罪疚解脱，迈向上主及一切造化的永恒。荣福之境。Each effort made on its behalf is offered for the single purpose of release from guilt to the eternal glory of God and His creation. 凡是以此为目标的课程都会直指天堂和上主的平安。Any every teaching that points to this point, straight to heaven and the peace of God. 这类教学能为你免除学习过程可能经历的一切痛苦、挣扎与惧怕。There is no pain, no trial, no fear that teaching this can fail to overcome. 上主必以自己的大能支持这类教诲，并且保证了他造福人类的无量功德。The power of God Himself supports this teaching and guarantees its limitless results. 你把精力投入那必会带来平安的大能吧。Join your own efforts to the power.That cannot fail and must result in peace. 没有人感受不到这一教诲的感召。No one can be untouched by teaching such as this. 如果你独独传授这一题，不可能经验不到上主德能的。You will not see yourself beyond the power of God if you teach only this. 你也不可能不受惠于这神圣的课题。他只愿为你恢复上主造化的天赋权利。You will not be exempt from the effects of this most holy lesson, which seeks but to restore what is the right of God's creation. 你每帮一人摆脱罪疚，都能助你认出自己的纯洁无罪。From everyone whom you accord release from guilt, you will inevitably learn your innocence.救赎之源即无边界，亦无止境。The circle of atonement has no end. 你每带一个人进入这安全又宁静之源，便会更加确信自己必在圈内。And you will find ever increasing confidence in your safe inclusion in the circle with everyone.You bring within its safety and its perfect peace. 平安必会降临于每一位平安之士。Peace then be unto everyone who becomes a teacher of peace. 因为平安即是任何人人本具的完美圣洁。For peace is the acknowledgement of perfect purity, from which no one is excluded.只要是上主创造的圣子，必然在这神圣之源内。Within its holy circle is everyone whom God created as his son. 喜乐成了结合的象征，没有人会被摒弃于圈外，独受罪疚的折磨。Joy is its unifying attribute with no one left outside to suffer guilt.Alone, 上主的德能会吸引每一个人进入这爱与合一的安全码头。The power of God draws everyone to its safe embrace of love and union. 安然立于圈内的你，又会吸引所有受苦的心灵加入这一平安圣地。Stand quietly.Within this circle and attract all tortured minds to join with you in the safety of its peace and holiness. 请你与我安住于此源之内，充当救赎之师，不再传播罪疚。Abide with me within it as a teacher of atonement, not of guilt.与我一起教学的人何其有福。Blessed are you who teach with me. 我们的力量不出于自己，而是来自天父。Our power comes not of us, but of our Father. 只有无罪的心灵才可能知道天父的真相，如同天父知道我们的无罪一样。In guiltlessness,We know him as he knows us guiltless. 我在圈内邀你进入我的平安。I stand with the circle calling you to peace. 与我同立于这一圣地，共同传扬平安的讯息。Teach peace with me and stand with me on holy ground. 帮每一个人一起天父赐给他的能力。Remember for everyone your father's power that he has given him. 切莫相信自己不配传扬他那完美平安的讯息。Believe not that you cannot teach his perfect peace. 别在圈外徘徊了，与我一起进入此源吧。Stand not outside, but join with me willing. 不要辜负了我，召集你和教导你的唯一 目的 fail not the only purpose to which my teaching calls you， 就是教导上主之子认出自己的纯洁无罪，恢复他受教之初的本来面目， restore to God his son as he created him by teaching him his innocence。十字架对救赎大业一无所用。The crucifixion had no part in the atonement. 只有复活才是我的救赎任务。Only the resurrection became my part in it. 复活象征了你的无罪本质已将你由罪疚解救出来了。That is the symbol of the release from guilt by guiltlessness. 凡是在你眼中有罪之人，你必会把他钉上十字架。Whom you perceive as guilty, you would crucify. 凡是在你眼中无罪之人，你才会还他清白。Yet you restore guiltlessness to whomever you see as guiltless. 十字架永远都是小我的最终目标。Crucifixion is always the ego's aim. 每一个人在他眼中都罪孽深重，他必须定罪在先，才好痛下杀手。It sees everyone as guilty, and by its condemnation, it would kill. 唯有圣灵之眼才会看到无罪本质，他温柔地教人释放恐惧，为他重建爱的国度。The Holy Spirit sees only guiltlessness, and in his gentleness, he would release from fear and re-establish the reign of love. 他的温柔充满了爱的力量，这力量来自上主，故不可能将人钉在十字架，也不可能深受十字架之苦。The power of love is in his gentleness, which is of God, and therefore cannot crucify, nor suffer crucifixion. 你所重建的圣殿变成了你的祭坛，也唯有透过你才有重建的可能。The temple you restore becomes your altar, for it was rebuilt through you. 你献给上主的每份礼物都成了你之所有。And everything you give to God is yours. 这是上主的创造法则，也是你恢复本然的必然处境。Thus he creates, and thus must you restore. 你愿把自己所见之人置于神圣的救赎之源内，或拒他于圈外，全凭你判断他该被钉死或应得救赎而定。Each one you see, you place within the holy circle, atonement or leave outside, judging him fit for crucifixion or for redemption. 你若领他进入这圣洁之园，你便会在园内与他同享安息。If you bring him into the circle of purity, you will rest there with him. 你若拒他于圈外，就会与他一起沦落圈外。If you leave him without, you join him there. 除非你已进入那远远超乎你极然圣境，否则不要再自行判断任何事了。Judge not except in quietness which is not of you. 莫将任何人排斥于救赎的祝福之外，而应以祝福将他领入圈内。Refuse to accept anyone as without the blessing of atonement and bring him into it by blessing him. 神圣性比具分享性，因为分享性正是构成神圣性的因素。 holiness must be shared, for therein lies everything that makes it holy. 欢欣地进入这一神圣之园吧，以平安的目光去看那些自以为在圈外的人。Come gladly to the holy circle and look out in peace on all who think they are outside. 不要排斥任何一人，因为这是你和他一生向往之境。Cast no one out, for here is what the seeks along with you. 来吧，让我们与他一起进入上主为所有的人设立的平安圣地，让我们在和平的崇高目标中结合为一个生命。Come, let us join him in the holy place of peace, which is for all of us, united as one within the cause of peace.
做完第十四章真理的教诲 Chapter 14 Teaching for Truth
第五节救赎之人 5 The Circle of Atonement
愿大家有一个生命充满的一天阿们我爱你哦